2013.
Motions. There are a total of 6 proposed resolutions for this meeting, which are all proposed by the Secretary for Financial Services and the Treasury. This Council will first deal with 3 proposed resolutions under the Interpretation and General Clauses Ordinance. The first motion seeks to amend the company's model articles notice. The second motion seeks to amend the company records inspection and provision of copies regulation. The third motion seeks to amend the company's non-Hong Kong companies regulation. As the 3 items of subsidiary legislation under the 3 motions are made in accordance with the company's ordinance and were scrutinized by the same subcommittee, this Council will proceed to a joint debate on the 3 motions. I'll first call upon the Secretary to speak on the 3 motions and move the first motion. When the debate comes to a close, this Council will first vote upon the first motion and then vote upon the second and third motions respectively. Whether or not the first motion is passed will not affect the moving of the second and third motions by the Secretary. This Council will now proceed to a joint debate. Members who wish to speak on the 3 motions will please press the request to speak button. I now call upon the Secretary for Financial Services and the Treasury to speak and move the first motion. President. President, in May this year, we tabled the 3rd batch of subsidiary legislation made under the new Companies Ordinance, CO, 28th of 2012 at the Legislative Council. The relevant subcommittee of the Legislative Council has put forward some suggestions to amend 3 pieces of subsidiary legislation under this batch. The administration agreed with these suggestions and is going to move 3 motions at today's council meeting to give effect to such amendments. The subcommittee has also completed the scrutiny of a set of court rules made by the Chief Justice under the new CO, which is subject to positive vetting procedure. I will soon move another motion to seek this Council's approval of the set of court rules. I now move the first of the 3 motions for amending the subsidiary legislation, which seeks to amend the company's model articles notice. Under the new CO, every company shall put in place a set of articles to specify the arrangements for its internal management. The company's model articles notice has prescribed 3 sets of model articles for adoption by different types of companies to be incorporated under the new CO. Same as the practice under the existing CO, Cap 32, a company may adopt at its own volition any relevant articles having regard to its own need. These model articles are intended for facilitating the incorporation of companies rather than imposing mandatory regulatory requirements. The subcommittee generally welcomed the 3 sets of model articles. While the subcommittee did not have difficulties with the intention in respect of the provisions relating to alternate directors, it proposed to refine the drafting of the provisions concerned to facilitate users to precisely understand the detailed arrangements. Meanwhile, the administration has reviewed other provisions and noted that certain provisions in the Chinese text may need some refinements to improve consistency between the Chinese and English versions. In this regard, this motion proposes a number of textual amendments without changing the intention underlying the provisions concerned. The proposed amendments were agreeable to the subcommittee, and I hope that members will support the motion. The second motion seeks to amend the company's records inspection and provision of copies regulation. This regulation was made pursuant to Sections 356 and 657 of the new CO. It prescribes the arrangements for access to company records kept by companies, including the requirements concerning the place for keeping records, the inspection of records, and the provision of copies of records. This regulation stipulates the time frame for the provision of copies of company records by a company. Under Section 11(1), a company is required to provide the copies within 5 business days after the date of receipt of a request or payment. The requirement seeks to minimize the compliance burden to the company while facilitating the obtaining of copies of company records by the requester within a reasonable period. During the scrutiny of this regulation, the subcommittee expressed concern that small and medium-sized enterprises might not be able to comply with the statutory requirement due to insufficient manpower. The subcommittee reached a consensus that the statutory time frame should be extended to 10 business days. This motion seeks to amend the relevant provision in light of such a consensus. The third motion is to amend companies non-Hong Kong companies regulation. The company's non-Hong Kong companies regulation was made pursuant to sections 804 and 805 of the new CO. It provides for detailed procedural matters relating to non-Hong Kong companies, that is NHKCs, for the implementation of the relevant provisions in Part 16 of the new CO. For example, detailed requirements on the documents to be submitted upon the registration of NHKCs and the delivery of annual returns. During the scrutiny of this regulation, the subcommittee offered comments on the drafting and technical aspects of certain provisions of the Chinese text. In this regard, we have agreed to make minor amendments to those provisions to improve their drafting and to better align with the English text. The amendments which have been agreed by the subcommittee will not change the intention underlying the provisions concerned. President, should the four motions under my name be passed today, this council would have completed the scrutiny of the three batches of 12 pieces of subsidiary legislation made under the new CO. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Wong Ting-kwong, Chairman of the Subcommittee, other members of the Subcommittee, as well as the staff of the Legislative Council Secretariat. During the past 6 months, they have provided many valuable comments and suggestions for refining the provisions. The completion of the scrutiny of the 12 pieces of subsidiary legislation would signify an important move towards the target of bringing into force the new CO in the first quarter of next year. In the coming few months, we'll continue with various preparatory work, including preparing a commencement notice for the new ordinance and updating the provisions in the relevant schedules in respect of consequential amendments in the fourth quarter of this year. I look forward to continuing our joint endeavor with members in concluding the final stage of the legislative exercise for the implementation of the new CO, with a view to establishing and strengthening Hong Kong's position as an international business and financial center. I move that the first motion under my name, as printed on the agenda in respect of the subsidiary legislation made under the new CO, for amending the company's model articles notice tabled at the council on the 29th of May 2013 be approved. I would appeal to members' support for this motion. Thank you, Chairman. I now put the question to you, and that is the motion moved by the Secretary for Financial Services and the Treasury be passed.
Mr. Wong Ting-kwong, President, as the Chairman of the Subcommittee on Subsidiary Legislation made under New Companies Ordinance, I report to this Council the task of the Subcommittee and our discussion on the success of subsidiary legislation at the new CO subject to negative vetting, and also our work at the scrutiny stage. The subcommittee held three meetings for discussion and scrutiny of the subsidiary legislation. We also received written submission from Hong Kong Institute of Directors. For companies' model articles notice, we have been provided a set of standard articles for public and private companies limited by shares and companies limited by guarantee. The new CO provides a company may adopt any or all of the provisions in the model articles. For alternate directors, some members point out that it is unclear about how an internal alternate or an external alternate director is to be counted for quorum of meetings and signing of written resolutions. The administration advises that a model articles that treat both an internal alternate and an external alternate equally, except that the appointment of the latter must be approved by resolution of the directors. Other than that, the model articles do not in substance distinguish them in terms of their rights, responsibilities, and powers. For the adoption of directors' written resolution, or rather, for counting of quorum, alternate director, whether internal or external, is to be counted once only to ensure a single alternate director can not alone constitute a quorum for a director's meeting and make decisions in the absence of other minds. For the adoption of a director's written resolution, the policy intention is that for an external alternate, he is only allowed to sign for one of his appointers. For an internal alternate, he is only allowed to sign for himself and or for one of his appointers. This would ensure that sufficient minds are being put to the issue to be resolved by written resolution. The subcommittee also notes that the administration, after reviewing the Chinese text of the notice, will propose technical amendments for improving consistency and to better align with the English text. The subcommittee has no objection to that. On the provision of copies of company records, some members consider the requirement of 5 business days under Section 11 a short duration. And it will be difficult for companies to comply with. In particular, small and medium-sized enterprises, SMEs, which have limited resources. Noting the lead time for provision of copy of information under the existing CO ranges between 7 to 20 calendar days, depending on the types of records and the relatively heavy penalty of a fine of 25,000 under Section 11(4). The subcommittee requests the administration to consider providing a lead time of 10 business days for provision of copies of company records. Having considered the subcommittee's opinions, the administration agreed to amend Section 11(1) to set down the lead time to 10 days instead of 5. We welcome this amendment. As for companies, non-Hong Kong companies regulation, we understand that under the new CO, documents have to be submitted to the director of the CR. This is applicable to non-Hong Kong companies. The subcommittee submit the amendments proposed by the administration concerning the Chinese text in order to enhance the drafting of the provisions. In April this year, the subcommittee scrutinized companies' inspection a revision of financial statements and reports, Amendment Regulation and Committee Disclosure of Information about Benefits of Directors, Amendment Regulation 2013. In response to the views of the subcommittee, the legal advisor of the subcommittee, the administration has proposed to make amendments to the two regulations. However, since the motion for extension of scrutiny period could not be dealt with at the council meeting of 24th April this year, it was no longer possible to amend the regulations. The company's revision of financial statements and reports amendment regulation 2013 is made by FS under section 450 of the new CO, and the company's disclosure of information about benefits of directors amendment regulation 2013 is also made under FS to effect the proposed amendments. The amendments has made minor textual amendment to the regulation and has confirmed that the rest of the proposed amendments in the two amendment regulations are the same as those originally proposed. Members have no objection. Companies fees regulation. The subcommittee notes that the fees items under the regulation are in line with the corresponding items of fee levels as stipulated in the existing CO, with elaboration or clarification where appropriate. However, companies limited by guarantee will be subject to an escalating scale for late filing of annual returns. The administration explains that this is to encourage compliance with the statutory filing requirement. The annual registration fee is subject to an escalating scale in case of late filing. Furthermore, members note that certain existing fee items, for example, those concerning an increase in nominal share capital or shares issued at a premium, have become obsolete and are not included in this regulation. And the subcommittee supports the company's fee regulation. The subcommittee will not move any CSA concerning the success of subsidiary legislation. President, on behalf of DAB, I would like to speak my views. The DAB supports the amendment. The third batch of six subsidiary legislation under new CO is to facilitate operation of companies and to cut down operating costs for them via technical amendments and administrative means. The administration considers the pragmatic needs of the companies and listened to members' views before putting forward the amendments. For example, the company's model articles regulation offer three sets of model tags for different kinds of companies to use and to choose from. And so the model articles are clearer and the companies can also set down clearer rules for there is also a system set up for alternate directors in relation to quorum forming and also written resolution. For non-members' right to speak at a meeting, there are regulations for companies to follow. Just now, I mentioned in the report that members are concerned with the quorum forming effect and the role of an alternate director in signing written resolution. Having taken into account members' views, the administration proposed amendments which will facilitate smooth decision-making for companies. For company records inspection and provision of copies regulation, companies are allowed to store their documents and related records in more than one place. This is because members raise that many local companies store their records and registration in a storehouse. That's why the administration allows flexibility for companies in terms of storing their records. And companies were first asked to submit copies of records within 5 days after receiving the request. Members thought that the period was too short and advised that the period should be extended to 10 days. This is to respond to the real operation of companies, and this is to enhance flexibility for the companies. To a certain extent, that will allow cost effectiveness in the companies. Now, many of the amendments are technical ones. The administration has to step up publicity and education to members of the public in relation to the amendments. Now, the subsidiary legislation involved disclosure of directors' interest and fees. These themselves are rather complicated, so the administration should give clear guidelines to the trade. For example, when the members raised that the accounting field should knowledge of the new amendments should be enhanced, especially the implementation of clauses related to liability. Members asked guidelines to be issued so that the trade can better grasp the amendments and to comply with them. And I would like to state my support for the amendments. Thank you. Does anyone wish to speak?
If not, I will now call upon the Secretary to reply. The debate will come to a close after the Secretary has replied. Secretary, yes, I want to thank Mr. Wong Ting-kwong for his speech. As I said right at the outset, the proposals are supported by the subcommittee, and so I beg to move. I now put the question to, and that is that the first motion moved by the Secretary be passed. Will those in favour please raise their hands, those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Secretary, you may now move the second motion. President, I move that this motion as printed on the agenda be passed. In other words, second item of legislation, in fact, on the 29th of May, the company records inspection and provision of copies regulation was tabled in the council. I now propose the question to you that it said the second motion moved by the Secretary be passed. I now put the question to you as stated. Will those in favour please raise their hands, those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Secretary, you may now move the third motion. President, I move that the motion as printed on the agenda be passed. This is a piece of subsidiary legislation, and it relates to the companies, non-Hong Kong companies regulation table before the council on the 29th of May. I now put a question, I now propose the question to you, that is that the third motion moved by the secretary be passed. I now put the question to you as stated. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed.
This council will now deal with the